girls basketball game between Darlington and Potosi Castle High Schools. To honor America and those defending our freedom, we ask those who are able to stand, remove your hats, and place your hand over your heart as our national anthem is sung by Summer Cole.
Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Potosi High School. Tonight, non-conference girls basketball action as the Potosi Castle Co-op welcomes in the Redbirds from Darlington. Darlington comes in tonight with a season record of 10-9. Potosi Castle enters tonight at 11-6. As we get ready for action here, starting lineups being announced. Let's take a look at the starters for both teams. First for Darlington, a senior number 4, Emma Riley, a senior number 10, Mia Guiley, a senior number 24, Greta Volkening, a junior number 35, Kayla Gullickson, and a senior number 41, Taylor Wadig. For the PC Co-op starting tonight on senior night here at Potosi High School, the senior number 1, Michaela Bauer, senior number 2, Jessica Noonan, senior number 10, Mackenzie Wiest, senior number 14, Allie Iam, and senior number 34, Kylie Ryder. We're underway. Potosi Castle will get it first possession against the Darlington man-to-man. Nice back cut. Jessica Noonan up with the layup. No good. Kept alive there by Wiest. And Darlington comes away with it. Darlington's first possession. PC in their 1-3-1 half-court zone to start things out tonight. Two teams, obviously, they don't see a lot of each other, so a little bit of a feeling out period here. As we mentioned, senior night here at Potosi. The seven seniors were honored before the game. Good patience so far out of Darlington as they try to solve that zone. Shot up from the lane, lefty by Wadig is off the rim, no good. And Bauer will bring it back for the co-op. Inside, Kylie Ryder up and in. Count the basket. Kylie will go to the line to try to complete the three-point play. Foul that time on number 35, Kayla Gullickson, her first and the team first, as PC jumps out to the early lead. Kylie now at the line trying to finish off the three-point play. Her free throw's up, and it's good. And once again, PC will drop back into that half court. Switching things up a little bit this time. As they sink in that 1-3-1 on the weak side. Folkening in the lane, shot up and blocked by Ryder. And we've got a whistle and a foul call. Foul that time is going to go on 14. Allie Iam, her first and team first. Our first sub of the game coming in for Darlington. Number 13, Aubrey McCarthy enters as Darlington will inbound under their own hoop. Looking to get it in. As Wadig, she'll come into Volkening with it. Volkening again driving the lane. Shot up is no good. Ryder clears and goes to Bauer with it as she'll push to the offensive end. Again, looking inside to Ryder. She'll fan it out. Take by Noonan. Whistles. It will stop, and they're going to call a foul before the shot, I believe. Now it looks like PC will enter on the baseline here. Quick break for Gullickson as she comes right back in for Wadig on the Darlington side. Foul that time was on Wadig, number 41, her first. Here's Wiest with it in the corner. She looked inside. Now back out high as they'll reset offense. Into Wiest in the post. Her turnaround jumper up and no good off the rim. Ball cleared by Darlington and they'll bring it up with Guiley with the ball. Down inside, up and short. We got a whistle stoppage. And looks like maybe over the back call on the rebound. That'll be on 35, Gullickson. It'll be her second early on. And she'll be replaced by number 23 for Darlington, Jalen Schwartz, on the floor for the first time. Lob pass inside. Ryder up with it, no good, but the foul's gonna be called. Kylie Ryder will go back to the line. This time for two attempts. Kylie's first attempt up on the way, off the rim, no good. She'll get a second shot. Here's her second attempt. That one is good. Two out of three from Ryder so far at the line. She's got all 4 points as PC takes the early advantage 4-0. Guiley with the three. Up, no good. Noonan will clear it out of there. She'll give to Bauer and they'll run offense. Come on. Ball's knocked away by Guiley. She'll bring it up the floor. Attack the rim. Her layup up, no good. Looks like it was tipped. And on the rebound, Noonan's going to be fouled. That one's going to be on number 10, Mia Guiley. And she'll be replaced by number 24, the sophomore, Jaden Evenstead, her first time on the floor tonight. And PC will enter and look to expand on their 4-0 lead. Ball tipped away by Volkening. PC will keep it as they'll enter at half court. Again, ball knocked away. They're going to say off Darlington, so PC will keep it. Noonan to trigger it in. And that one's going to be turned over and we'll go the other way as Darlington takes over possession. Evenstead now for the Redbirds will bring things up the floor. This is Volkening. Now to Schwartz. Ball gets reversed to Riley. And now all five have touched it. As McCarthy gets into the action as well. Good patience so far from Darlington as they look to attack this 1-3-1. Down inside to Schwartz. She'll go to the high post. Shot is up and good. First two on the night, that's from Audrey McCarthy as the Redbirds get on the board. 4-2, 13 and a half minutes to play here in the first half. Nice back cut from Noonan. She goes up, ball's tipped away, and we'll go back to the Redbirds. Drive down the lane that time by Evenstead's going to draw the foul. Call that time is on 34, Kylie Ryder. Subs in for PC. 24, Emily Bierman comes on the floor, as does number 5, Cassie Cooley. As Darlington will inbound underneath their own hoop. This is Evenstead to trigger things in for the Redbirds. Schwartz with a nice cut, but has a shot knocked away. Cooley with the block that time as Potosi Castle looks to push. Got it inside to Bauer, but had to throw it off the leg. So PC will keep possession here on their own end. Noonan looking for somebody, looking. Finally brings it into Cooley. Ball is bounced off the foot of McCarthy. And the co-op will keep it on their own end. Back cut from Bierman, just going to handle the pass. And a turnover will send it back over to the Redbirds. Ball knocked away. Nice anticipation that time by Michaela Bauer. Bauer goes for the steal again, comes up empty this time. Ball inside to McCarthy, up, shot's blocked. They come down with it at the same time. Jump ball's going to be called. And alternate possession is going to remain with Darlington. McCarthy and Cooley came down with that one simultaneously. So jump ball called. Here's Riley for three. Shot up and good. Emma Riley with a three-pointer. Darlington takes the lead 5-4, 12 minutes left in the first half. Cooley down the lane, her shot up and good off, not good off the board. She'll try to hustle it down and does come up with it. Good hustle that time for Maddie Cooley. Cassie Cooley. Here's Cassie again, up and no good. Got a little too deep under the basket. McCarthy, nice move with the right hand, up and good, off the board. Aubrey McCarthy with her second basket of the game. Looking to lob inside that time. Nice help defense out of the Redbirds. Here's Riley again for another three. Again, up and good for Emma Riley, her second three. And we've got a timeout, PC. 10:22 remaining in the first half. Darlington has jumped out to a 10-4 lead here in action. With this break, time for us to send out a special thank you to our sponsors for tonight's game. The Potosi Brewing Company, A&E Designs, Epic Construction, the Potosi Saloon, Oyen Technologies LLC, Haverland's Bar, and the Potosi Sports Boosters. Thank you to our sponsors, without whom this broadcast would not be possible. As we talked about, slow going here early on as both teams kind of felt trying to feel each other out. Darlington, though, has got a couple three-point hoops out of Emma Riley to open up this 10-4 lead with 10:22 remaining here in the first half. As they come back on the floor, we take a look at PC, Bauer, Noonan, Bierman, Cooley, and Ryder on the floor for PC. New faces in the game for Darlington. Number 15, Kaylee Schwartz on the floor for the first time. As well as number 5, Maddie Wadig on the floor for the first time for Darlington. Noonan with the jumper, no good. And it's going to go back over to Darlington. Good half-court man-to-man defense so far out of Darlington as PC continues to look for the answer. Now coming off the bench for PC, number 3, Ellie Pierce will join in for the first time. As Darlington looks to expand their 10-4 lead. McCarthy in the post. Nice left-handed hook that time. Aubrey McCarthy with her third basket. She's got 6. Bauer finds Ryder inside. Her kick back out to Bierman. Her 3 on the way is up and good. Emily Bierman didn't start tonight with it being senior night, but she's on the floor now and hits her first 3 attempt of the night. Jalen Schwartz with a shot, left it short. But Darlington's going to offensive rebound. Here's Kaylee Schwartz outside. Her three from the top is good. Kaylee Schwartz off the bench with a three. Lob looking inside again. Not there. Turner will give it back. Here's McCarthy again. She'll kick back out this time. Schwartz, who just hit the three. Again with the left hand. McCarthy, nice defense at that time by Kylie Ryder. Nowhere for McCarthy to go. And the ball goes back to PC. Here's Bierman into the lane, keeps her dribble. Nice high-low pass. There's McCarthy again. She's up to eight. And the Redbirds stretch it to a 10-point advantage with 7 minutes left here in the first half. Here's Pierce with the jumper from the corner. Her three up and good. Ellie Pierce, big three-pointer. Cuts the lead to seven. Ball stolen by Kylie Ryder. She'll keep her dribble as she tries to attack. Now back to Bierman. She'll get to the rim. Shot up and a foul call. Foul that time on number five, Maddie Wadig, her first. And Emily Bierman will head to the line to shoot two. First free throw for Emily is off the back iron, no good. Here's Bierman for her second attempt on the way, and it's short. No good. Schwartz for Darlington out of there with the rebound. Looking inside again that time, Darlington, but thrown away. 6:13 till halftime. That was Bierman's three attempt. No good this time from the wing. Starlington will bring it back up with Evenstead. Shot on the way, no good. Jalen Schwartz is going to keep it alive. And then thrown away by Darlington as it'll go back to PC. Here's Ryder inside, her shot up, no good. Loose ball is taken away by Wadig from Darlington. And now Evenstead will bring it. 30-second timeout called by Darlington that time. 4:51 till halftime. Darlington 17, Potosi Caswell 10. Again, a special thank you to our sponsors, the Potosi Brewing Company, A&E Designs, Epic Construction, the Potosi Saloon, Oyen Technologies LLC, Haverland's Bar, and the Potosi Sports Boosters. Thank you again for making tonight's broadcast possible. Low scoring here in the first half. Again, both teams trying to fill each other out. Darlington's half-court man pressure has caused some problems for PC. See what they can find for an answer. As we come out of the timeout, Darlington's basketball, no under on the sideline. And PC will stay with the same lineup. Bierman, Cooley, Ryder, Noonan, and Pierce. PC now in their half-court man defense. Nice back cut by Jalen Schwartz. She goes up and is fouled. Good back cut. She'll get rewarded by going to the line. Foul was on 34 Kylie Ryder that time. Her second. Only the team third. Here's Jalen Schwartz at the line. Her first free throw's up. No good off the rim. Michaela Bauer will return. She comes for Kylie Ryder, so PC will definitely become a little smaller with their lineup on the floor. Second shot on the way by Schwartz is up and good. All net for Jalen Schwartz on the second attempt. Here's Ellie Pierce in the lane, tries a split two, and we've got a foul call. Foul that time on 23, Jalen Schwartz. It's her second. And Ellie Pierce will go to the line as McCarthy comes back in to replace Schwartz. Ellie Pierce, 3 points so far tonight. Her first free throw attempt on the way, up and no good on the bonus attempt. And Darlington will bring it back with their 8-point lead. Shot up and no good. Gonna stay with Darlington. Taylor Wiggett had caught it inside that time, just couldn't finish, left it short. Again, that's Taylor waiting inside. This time draws the foul, though. Foul was on number 5, Cassie Cooley. Her first and team fourth. First free throw on the way from Wadig is no good. She'll get a second attempt. Second free throw on its way, and that one's good. Taylor Wadig with her first point on the night. Extend the lead to 19-10. Just under 4 minutes to play here in the first half. Bauer shot fake. Now we'll bring it back out, reset. Ball tipped away, on the floor loose. We've got a jump ball call, and it'll stay with PC. Coach Bierman will get Iam and Ryder back into the game with 3:26 till half. They'll replace Cooley and Pierce. As Noonan will enter, well, check that, Bierman will enter it in from the sideline. Here's Allie Iam, 3-point on the way, up Off the rim, no good. Cleared out of there by Taylor, waiting for Darlington. Here's Volkening for her three on the way. No good, off the mark. And out of bounds, we'll go back to PC. Bauer in the lane, her left-handed shot up on the way, and it'll go. Michaela Bauer with her first two on the night. Nice left-handed layup on a spin, and she'll be rewarded at the line trying to complete that three-point play for Michaela. Free throw on the way. Up, no good, off the front iron. We've got a whistle. Looks like inadvertent whistle. Official turns around to look at the score table and thinks, why did I blow my whistle? So Darlington will keep possession on the inadvertent whistle. 2:34 till half. 19-12, Darlington with the lead. Taken away by Bauer. And then Riley's going to follow her. Michaela Bauer will go back to the free throw, and this time to shoot the bonus. As that's Riley's first foul, but the ninth as a team. So still 1-1 here. Michaela Bauer steps to the stripe. Her first free throw on the way. It's up and no good. PC early on, 2 of 8 from the foul line here in the first half. Got to do a better job of taking advantage of those opportunities. Good defense this time by PC. Looking inside. Here's Wadig inside. Her left hand up and good. Taylor Wadig. Kayla Bauer got caught that time with a little size mismatch. They did a nice job of finding Wadig, and she finished in close to the rim. Here's Bierman now. Her three-point jumper on the way up. No good, but Noonan's going to come out of there with the offensive rebound. Now Ryder at the foul line. She'll go back. And now Bauer with the long three. Off the board, no good. Ryder's going to offensive rebound, and PC will get a third attempt. Here's Allie Iam, her jumper, short, no good. Three good looks that time from PC, just couldn't get a shot to go. Again, looking inside to that mismatch into Wadig. Nice help that time. And a whistle. And we've got a foul call. Foul that time on Jessica Noonan. As Taylor Wade to go back to the line. First free throw up and good for Taylor Wadig. Here is Wadig's second attempt on the way. It's up and rolls in as well. 1 minute left to play here in the half, 23-12. Darlington out on top. Bierman keeps her dribble alive and then gets fouled. Foul that time on 41, Taylor Wadig. As Bierman will go to the line to shoot two. Bierman's first is up and good. Checking in that time, number 21, Brennick Rosen for Darlington. As Bierman will go for her second free throw attempt, this one up and no good for Emily. Still that 1-3-1 out of Potosi Cassville. Ball is tipped away, and they're going to say off Guiley. As PC will get the ball back with 34 seconds to play. See if they can get the last attempt here to cut this lead down to single digits. Bauer tax lane. Her pass just off the fingertips of Iam, and on the turnover, Darlington will get it back with 23 seconds to play. Again, looks like we had an inadvertent whistle. Darlington bench yelling something. The official thought he was asking for a timeout. And they'll enter in. Bierman now up pressuring. And it's going to get called for the blocking foul. Only the team six, so Darlington will inbound again. That was Bierman's first. Here's Riley with it. Now Grossen way out high. She'll look inside into McCarthy, up and no good. And at the buzzer, the three-quarter shot from Doonan is short, and we get to halftime. At a halftime, Darlington with the 10-point lead. They lead the co-op 23-13. Quick look at scorers in that first half unofficially for Darlington. Jalen Schwartz with one. Taylor Waitig with five. Kaylee Schwartz with three. Emma Riley with six on 2 3-pointers. And leading the way, Aubrey McCarthy off the bench with eight. For PC, 2 points out of Michaela Bauer. Three from Ellie Pierce, 4 points for Emily Bierman, and 4 points for Kylie Ryder. Low scoring first half as Darlington goes to the locker room up 23-13. As we get ready for this halftime, again, a special thank you to our sponsors tonight: Potosi Brewing Company, A&E Designs, Epic Construction, the Potosi Saloon, Oyen Technologies, Haverland's Bar, and the Potosi Sports Boosters. Darlington with the 10-point lead at halftime. Back with more action in the second half. We're back, getting ready for second half action, with Darlington holding a 23-13 lead on the Potosi Castle Co-op. A couple observations from that first half. Obviously low scoring, as PC has struggled with that Darlington half-court man-to-man pressure. See what they can come up with an answer here in the second half. Also, the foul line. Darlington finished the half 4 of 6 from the foul line. PC only 3 of 10 from the charity stripe in that first half. Leaving points on the floor. That really could have cut into this 10-point lead here at halftime. We've got PC back on the floor with their starters. Bauer, Noonan, Ryder, Iam, and Wiest. And here comes Darlington as they'll enter it in to start this second half as they lead 23-13. Ball tipped away inside. Noonan comes away with it. Here's Bauer. She'll look to push, create some offense that way. She gets down the lane, all the way up, and a whistle. Foul call coming on Darlington. Foul that time was called on number 24. First free throw up and good by Bauer. Again, the foul that time was on number 24, Greta Volkening, her second on the game, as Bauer gets her second attempt. This one's on the way, and it's good as well. All net on both attempts for Michaela Bauer. Only 2 in that first half. She's matched it already. Still that 1-3-1 half-court defense. They go into the post. Now kick back outside. Ball entered in the post. Nice post-to-post pass to Waited, cutting down the lane. Her shot up and no good. Ryder comes away with it. And Bowers caught from behind and had it tipped away. Ball is loose now. And Darlington will bring her back up the floor. They get into the post to Waited. She kicks back out to Volkening. Nice cut again that time. Up and good this time for Taylor Waited. 5 in the first half from Taylor, her first 2 here in the second. Here's Noonan with it, has the ball tipped away. Riley with it, she'll stop, and knocked away by Noonan. Good hustle that time as she got back into the play to knock the ball away. 25-15 as we just start the second half here. PC looking to make a little bit of a spurt. Starts on this end on the defensive end as they try to look for a stop. Here's Riley with it from the corner up. No good. Noonan's going to run it down. She looks ahead to Bauer. Bauer on the bust out with the left hand up and rolls off. No good. And then frustration foul, Michaela Bauer that time. Had a good look, just wouldn't go, and then a frustration foul. She reached in, picked up the foul. Be the first team foul in the second half for PC. Also, Michaela's first foul on the night. Shot up, no good. Again, Noonan comes out of there with the rebound. A little pressure in the backcourt, but Iam will bring it up. Now finds Bauer and taken away. This is Volkening. Stops, no good. Bauer clears. And now Michaela Bauer will set things up. I'm looking inside. Nice move, Kylie Ryder. She goes up for the reverse and knocked away. Taylor Waited got a piece of it, and she'll bring it back up herself. All the way down the lane. Her layup up and good on the left-hand side for Taylor Waited. And a quick timeout from Coach Brad Bierman and the PC team. 15:27 left in the game. Darlington 27, Potosi Castle 15. A thank you again to our sponsors tonight, the Potosi Sports Boosters, Haverland's Bar, Oyen Technologies, the Potosi Saloon, Epic Construction, A&E Designs, and the Potosi Brewing Company. We had mentioned earlier tonight, Potosi Cassville finished in that gauntlet of tough games. They had 6 games in 9 days, have come out of that still standing, still with their 11-6 record above 500. After tonight, they'll get back into conference action as Thursday night they travel to Shelbyville. Our next home game that we'll have for you is Friday night, as the Potosi boys will welcome in Pecatonica in the Six Rivers crossover game. Back to action. PC with it. Bierman has come on the floor for Potosi Cassville as well as Cooley. Here's Noonan with it. Her shot on the way up, no good. Tipped around, and Riley will come out of there. Here's Guiley with it. She gets in the lane and kicks. Jessica Noonan takes that one away. Nice defense that time from Noonan. And Bauer's going to draw the foul. Foul that time was on number 41, Taylor Wadig. That's Wadig's third, as she'll have a seat. Bauer lost the dribble that time as she came around with the left hand, taken away by Darlington. This is even said with it. Now back outside to Guiley. Here's Javen Schwartz, who's checked back into the game. Inside to Gullickson at the high post. Now Volkening, dribble penetrates and then kicks back out. Guiley does the same. Here's Volkening with her jumper on the way. Off the front rim, no good. And Bierman will try to push. She looks ahead to Noonan. Noonan on the left-hand side with the left hand up. No good. Gets her own rebound. Goes back up. And a whistle. Foul is going to be on Jalen Schwartz that time. Noonan will go to the line to shoot two. Noonan, PC's leading scorer, at 10.9 points a game, is scoreless so far tonight. She'll try to take care of that here at the line. Her first free throw is on the way and good. There's Jessica Noonan's first point of the night. See if that gets her going. The foul that time was on Jalen Schwartz. It's her third. As Noonan will take her second attempt. Jess on the way up front rim and rolls in. Two free throws from Jessica Noonan. And the lead goes back to 10. 27-17, 13:45 left here in the game. Schwartz three-pointer up and no good. Cooley's gonna run it down. Double team there, she'll find Pierce. And now to Bierman, as Emily Bierman will bring the ball up the floor. Keeps her dribble alive. Now we'll back it out of there. Look inside to Kylie Ryder. One dribble and kicks back out to no one. And going to be turned over on the over and back call. Taken away, Jessica Noonan with the clean strip that time. And PC again will look to cut it into single digits. Bierman with the dribble. This is Pierce in the corner. Pull-up jumper off the rim, no good. Cooley fights for the rebound. She'll kick it out of there. Nice job by Cassie Cooley to find Noonan. Noonan now gets to the lane. Her shot up, left it short. She reaches for the rebound, but no good as Evenstead will come out of there with it for Darlington. And we've got a timeout, Darlington, with 12:25 remaining in the ballgame. Darlington holds on to that 10-point lead, 27-17. Both teams with 4 points here in the second half, as that 10-point lead stays just as it was at halftime. Our sponsors, one more time, a huge thank you to them for making this event possible tonight. Potosi Sports Boosters, Haverland's Bar, Oyen Technologies, Potosi Saloon, Epic Construction, A&E Design, and the Potosi Brewing Company. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Please frequent those businesses and tell them how appreciative you are of making this and all of our broadcasts possible. Well, we said low scoring in the first half. It's continued here in the second half. Second half for Darlington, Taylor Wadig's got 4 on 2 baskets. That's it. And for PC, they've got 2 free throws from Michaela Bauer and 2 free throws from Jessica Noonan. And that's it for them. If either team could go on a spurt here, could really open this game up. Be Darlington basketball as we come out. Kaylee Schwartz will enter the ball in right in front of the scorer's table. Looks like a 2-3 half-court zone this time out of PC. Ball is tipped, and Noonan will come out of there again. And a whistle. Looks like Jessica stepped on the end line. Here's Aubrey McCarthy coming in for Darlington. She had a nice first half, led them with 8 in that first half. She'll get it in the post again. Her shot is up and will roll in. McCarthy picks up right where she left off in the first half. First in the game, up to double digits as she now has 10. And the lead goes to 12 points. Now looking inside, nice catch inside by Ryder. Her shot up off the back iron, no good. And Darlington will clear. Good look that time for Kylie Ryder, just couldn't get it to go. And turned over. Here's Noonan with it against McCarthy's pressure. She'll get it to Bierman as Emily will bring the ball to the floor. She'll look inside again into Kylie Ryder. Couple dribbles, looking to kick it back out. 3-pointer on the way from Noonan, up, all net. Jessica Noonan. Nothing in the first half, but that's 5 here now in the second half as she does cut that lead into single digits. 29-20, Darlington still with the lead. Potosi Castle looking for their run. Stuck on the baseline now and taken away by Kylie Ryder. Good D that time out of PC. Here's Bierman again as she'll push it up, look for another hoop. On the spin, her layup up and good off the backboard. Emily Bierman. Here's McCarthy in the post. Post move up, no good. On the weak side, fought for. And we've got a jump ball call as it's stuck on the floor. And it'll go to Potosi Cassville. Bauer comes back in the game as she replaces Pierce. Ball tipped away. That half-court man-to-man pressure again as Evenstead got her hand on the pass attempt. Knocked it out of bounds, and Bierman will enter it. She throws into Bauer in the backcourt, and a little too aggressive that time from Evenstead. For or even said that's her first foul. It'll be the fourth on the team. Here's Bierman again with that runner. Up, no good this time. Cooley fights for the ball and gets it out to Noonan. Her three on the way, halfway down and out. And again, Cooley working for that offensive rebound but knocked it out of bounds. It'll go over to Darlington. 29-22, 10:09 left in the ballgame. Potosi Castle in that 2-3 half-court defense. Here's Wadig with it. Her shot up, no good. Rebound fought for between Wadig and Cooley. We've got another jump ball call as they both came down with it. And this time it'll stay with Darlington. As they'll inbound underneath their own basket with Evenstead triggering the ball in. Ball out high to Wadig. Her left-handed dribble gives it up. That time ball got off to number five, Maddie Wadig. She's fouled on her way in. Foul that time was on number 24, Emily Bierman, her second, team second, as first free throw is up and good. Maddie Wadig with her first point tonight. Second one on the way, up. That one's off the mark, and Noonan will clear. Bierman with it, she goes to Bauer. Michaela will bring the ball to the floor and try to set the offense. High screen, and then thrown away. Seal that time was number 12, Zoe Zuberbühler, her first action. And then she was fouled by Emily Bierman, her third foul. Darlington will inbound and bring it up the floor. Tip by Bierman, but Darlington will keep it. Here's Zuberbühler with it again. Now McCarthy knocked away by Bierman, nice block shot. As Ryder comes down with it, a lot of contact inside, no call. And now a whistle as Wade goes up for a second attempt. Coach Bierman looking for the original foul. Taylor Wade to get the line. Her first free throw is up and good. The foul that time was called on Michaela Bauer, her second. Team fourth, as both teams now with 14 fouls. Taylor Wadig will get her second attempt. It's on the way. It's left short, no good. And Cassie Cooley out of there with the rebound. Inside, shot up, no good from Ryder. Wadig runs it down. Knocked away by Noonan that time, but Darlington will keep possession. Zuberbühler will trigger it in. Evenstead down the lane, left hand up and good. Jaden Evenstead with her first two tonight. And the lead goes back to 11. Pass that time, fumbled away. Turnover will give it back to Darlington. Knocked away, taken away by PC. Here comes Bauer with it. Again, tip from behind. But Noonan ends up with it. Her shot up and good. Jessica Noonan, right place, right time. Caught the fumble, went right up with it and finished. Cut the lead to 9. Cross-court pass now knocked away by Noonan. Left jumper on the way. No good this time from Evenstead. Bierman out of there with it. Again, some contact, no whistle. And it's going to be lost out of bounds. The officials are going to go ahead and issue a bench warning on PC. 7:25 to play, 9-point lead. Ball inside to Wadig. Offensive foul called that time. Lowered the shoulder, tried to create a little space, and was called for the offensive foul. That's Wadig's fourth. The Schwartz will come back on the floor for her. And PC will look to cut into this lead. Noonan with it on the wing. High screen coming. Said cross-court pass taken away. Left-handed layup up, no good. Followed by Jalen Schwartz. She goes up with her shot, left it short. And Bierman will come out of there with it. Her spin, and she'll lose it out of bounds. Turnover, match by turnover, and it'll go back over to Darlington. 6:55 remaining. Darlington 33, Potosi Castroville 24. Again, the co-op here looking for a spurt. Get a couple stops and a couple nice shots on the other end. Look inside to Gullickson. Her dribble, she'll kick wide. Here's a three on the way, left short for Maddie Wadig. And Cooley comes out of there with it. Look inside, Ryder with it, in too deep. She'll kick back out. Jumper on the way, three on the way from Emily Bierman off the mark. It'll go out of bounds and go back to Darlington. Here's Volkening checking back in for the Redbirds. One-three-one look again for PC. They try to create some action here on the defensive end. Riley with the jumper from the corner, missed it. Run down by Pierce, her left-handed dribble. She'll try to push. She looks ahead to Bauer, who'll collect it, go up, and draw the whistle on the foul. All that time called on number 20, Jade Nevenstead. Her second, team sixth. Michaela Bauer will go to the line to shoot two. First is up and all net for Michaela. Jessica Noonan checks back in for Pierce. As Michaela gets ready for her second attempt. On the way, it's up, that's good as well. 33-26. Lead cut to seven. Ball tipped away, Volkening will keep it. In some distress now. We've got a whistle, and we've got a timeout call before the turnover happens, so it'll stay Darlington ball after this 30-second timeout. 5:18 to go. Potosi Castroville has cut the lead down to seven. Darlington still leads 33-26. Potosi Castroville has cut 3 points into that halftime advantage. They were down 10 at half, 23-13. And have outscored Darlington in the second half, 13-10. Again, as they look to get back into it. It'll be Darlington basketball when they come out. Again, they got the timeout called just before the turnover occurred. A look at the foul situation. Potosi Castle with four team fouls. Darlington with six. So PC will be shooting from here on out in the bonus situation, as any fouls should happen here for the last 5:18 of the ball game. PC looks like they're going to stay in that 2-3 zone this time down the floor. See what Darlington decides to do. Here's Evenstead, pull up, pop up, no good. Cooley with the rebound on the weak side. And PC will have a chance to cut it to five. Noonan with it on the dribble, her pop, no good, left it short. Good challenge that time from Gullickson to make that a tough shot. And Darlington will come back with it. High post to Schwartz. She goes out to Riley. And now back to Evenstead. Here's Evenstead with it. No good. She'll kick back out to Schwartz. And now Volkening. Gullickson continues to work in the post. They try to force it into her. And the ball's knocked away and taken by Emily Bierman. Up to Noonan. She'll look inside to Riley. Up, no good. Kylie Ryder had a good look that time. Just couldn't finish inside with a post move. And as PC will look for another stop. Here's Schwartz with it at the foul line. Volkening and Riley as she's running the baseline back and forth from corner to corner. Again, ball loose, taken away by Bauer. She will attack the rim. Her layup left short, no good. And even set out of there with it. Couple good opportunities the last two times down the floor for PC. Just couldn't get a shot to go. Here's Jalen Schwartz with it. Her jumper on the way, no good. Off the back iron. Ball's tipped away and Schwartz is going to run it down in the corner. Now Volkening, side's better of it. And they will reset offense. Inside to Jalen Schwartz, kick back out. Here's Evenstead with the three attempt on the way, no good. Cooley on the weak side, gets up and gets the rebound, and a quick whistle. Foul coming on Darlington. Foul's on number 23, Jalen Schwartz on that rebound. Be Schwartz's fourth, and team seventh, so that will send Cassie Cooley to the line to shoot the bonus. 3:06 remaining, 33-26, as Cassie Cooley, the sophomore, steps to the line. First free throw is up and spins out of there, no good. Patience from Darlington as they know they have that lead, but now tipped away and taken away. SPC will get another chance to try to cut into this thing with 2:30 left in the ballgame. Here's Noonan's three on the way. It's up. No good. And McCarthy's going to get the rebound. That's four straight possessions for PC's had a good opportunity. Here's number five as Bauer picks up the loose ball and attacks the rim. Contact, late whistle, but foul is going to be called. Foul that time on the block was on Jaden Evenstead. Her third, teammate as Michaela Bauer will go back to the line to shoot two more. First free throw on the way, off the back iron, no good. And Darlington will come with a hockey line change. It's five in, five out. Five fresh players on the floor for Darlington. Bauer's going to get her second attempt. It's up. And that one is too strong. And rebound there by Schwartz. You've got Wading and Schwartz both on the floor for Darlington. I believe both with four fouls. Nice job again from Michaela Bauer. She took the ball away. Nice steal that time. And then was pushed out of bounds to draw the foul again. Michaela Bauer will go right back to the line to shoot the bonus again. Foul that time was on number 12, Zoe Zubibuller, her first, team ninth. So from here on out, Potosi Cats will shoot two. Free throw for Michaela, no good. Off the back iron, Schwartz with the rebound. Here comes Riley with the ball. Potosi Castle has extended that pressure with under 2 minutes to play. Taken away by Bierman. Nice job, nice strip as she kept it alive. Bauer finds a streaking Noonan. Her layup up and good. Jessica Noonan for two and a quick timeout from PC. Minute 37 to play, 33-28 as PC tries to work it back their way into this. With under 2 minutes to play here again, a chance to thank our sponsors tonight, Potosi Brewing Company, A&E Designs, Epic Construction, Potosi Saloon, Oyen Technologies, Haverland's Bar, and Potosi Sports Boosters. Potosi done a nice job on the defensive end here the last number of possessions. They've had some good looks on the offensive end, just haven't gotten the ball to drop, whether it be free throws or good shot attempts. But finally that time on a loose ball, Michaela Bauer looked ahead, found a streaking Jessica Noonan, and her layup was up and good to cut this lead down to five with a minute 37 to play. Potosi Castle will come back on the floor with the same group. They're going to show some forward court pressure now. Looks like they're in their 1-3-1 full court. We've got one deep, and Riley's going to try to find Schwartz down deep. Her pass inside to number five. Maddie Wadig is up and no good, but we got a foul call. Foul that time was on Noonan, her second. As Maddie Wadig will go to the line to shoot two. Her first free throw's up and no good. Off the back iron. Here comes Wadick's second attempt. This one on the way. Up and again, no good. A nice rebound that time by Evenstead to keep the ball alive. And we've got a whistle. Foul called on Bauer as she went for the steal. That's only the team six, so Darlington will get away inbound. Bauer with her third. Taken away by Bauer on the steal. She'll get to the rim. Here's Zubibuller trying to chase her down. Layup up and good for Michaela Bauer. Lead down to three. Minute 18 to play. Full court pressure from PC. Darlington will break the pressure. Get it ahead to Maddie Wadick. Evenstead with it now. She goes to Kaylee Schwartz. As they try to run clock. This is Zoe Zubibuller with it. She'll pick up the dribble, find Wadig. Down under a minute to play, and we've got a whistle and a foul call. That's a 17th foul. That'll put Darlington in the line in the bonus for Maddie Wadig. Fifty-one seconds to play, 33-30 as Maddie Wadig goes to the line. PC needs a box out and a rebound here. Shots on the way, it's no good. But again, Gullickson with the big, strong offensive rebound that time. Kayla Gullickson will go to the stripe this time. She was fouled in the act of shooting and will get two. 49.8 to play. Her free throw on the way, and it's good. All net for Kayla Gokes, and her first point tonight could turn out to be a big one as she makes it a four-point lead. Second free throw on the way. It's up. It's no good. And this time cleared out of there by PC. Bierman looks ahead to Bauer as they'll try to hurry up. Bauer trying to get to the rim. Cut off there by Zuberbühler. She now gets into the lane, and her shot up, no good. Ball tipped away. Jalen Schwartz comes down with it. Jaden Evenstead draws the foul that time from Emily Bierman. And Evenstead will go to the line to shoot the bonus. 34-30, 29.2 seconds remaining. Two timeouts for each team left. Left-handed free throw on the way up. No good. Kylie Ryder with it. Here's Bierman as she looks to push. She'll go cross court to Noonan. Her jumper on the way. It's up, and it's good on that. And a quick timeout from PC. Jessica Noonan caught, went up into her jump shot, all net. 19 seconds to play here at Potosi High School. The lead is cut to two, 34-32. A check of the scoreboard and where we're at. If things are correct on the scoreboard, PC would have one timeout remaining, Darlington with two remaining. Both teams with nine team fouls apiece. That means both teams will shoot double bonus on any foul. And the big thing, the score, Darlington still clings to a 34-32 lead with 19 seconds to play. Well, we'll see where we're at here. Assume full court pressure out of PC, looking for that steal. If they don't get it, look for them to foul right away as they got to stop the clock to try and get the ball back. One thing that has to happen that they've struggled with in a couple possessions now, they've gotten missed free throws but haven't been able to rebound a missed free throw. So I'm sure Coach Bierman will mention that. Here's Darlington looking to inbound. A lot of contact, no call. Oh, and a steal by Bauer. She's going to get to the rim. Her shot up, off the front rim, no good. It's knocked around. Bierman trying to reach for it. We've got a whistle. And we've got Potosi Cast football, 9.1 seconds remaining in a two-point lead for Darlington. Now we've got a timeout on the floor. 30-second timeout is going to be called by Potosi Cassville. That will be their final timeout, I believe. There you go. Just entered it on the board. They have zero timeouts remaining. Darlington with two. As we set the action here, it'll be Potosi Cassville's ball here on the sideline in the corners where it looks like they're going to enter the ball in. 9.1 seconds remaining in a two-point lead for Darlington. As they come out of the timeout, we'll take a look here for PC, who they have on the floor. I'd assume it's going to stay the same as they've been. It's Bierman, it's Ryder, it's Cooley, it's Noonan. And it's Bauer, same group that's been out there. They will enter it in here from the corner. Ball comes into Ryder. Ryder back to Noonan. 6 seconds to play. She drives into the lane, has it tipped away, out to Bierman. Her three on the way, off the front rim, no good. And that's how it'll end. Tried to dribble, penetrate. Fumbled it a little bit, but found an open Emily Bierman for a three. She had a good look at it. It was a deep shot, but just off the front rim. And we've got a final. Darlington 34, Potosi Cassville 32. We'll do a quick total of scores here, share with what we come up with. All right, here we go. Final scores unofficially for Potosi Cassville. 3 points tonight from Ellie Pierce. 4 from Kylie Ryder. 6 points out of Emily Bierman tonight. 8 from Michaela Bauer. And leading the way, Jessica Noonan with 11. All those 11 in the second half. And she did everything she could to bring Potosi back into it. Trailing by 10 at half and end up losing by the closest of margins, 34-32. Great game tonight. Again, thanks to our sponsors for making it possible for you to view it. Potosi Brewing Company, A&E Designs, Epic Construction, the Potosi Saloon, Oyen Technologies, Haverland's Bar, and the Potosi Sports Boosters. Thanks for those sponsors of giving us a chance to show this close game tonight. The girls back in action again on Thursday night as they travel to Shelbsburg. Our next home action, Friday night, Potosi boys in action in the Six Rivers crossover as they match up against the Pecatonica Vikings. Thanks, everyone. Have a great night. We'll look to see you again on Friday night with boys action.